Hey everyone, I'm back with another unboxing today and I'm really excited about this because I'm really into like home labs and NASes and things like that. What's the plural of NAS? Is it NASes or NAS or NICE? Or anyway, it doesn't matter. The point is I'm really into, you know, home lab stuff in general and storing way too much media, whether it's on hard drives or NVMe drives. So this LinkStation N2 is something that's very exciting to me. So the actual outer packaging is, you know, nice and sleek. In silver then you've actually got the model name saying LinkStation. But for now, actually, let's look in the box. So if you didn't want to actually, you know, build an entire NAS yourself, you could just buy this and it's super easy and super convenient. So yeah, let's actually check out the product. So I always like to weigh things first. In terms of the actual weight, it's 925 grams, which is a good weight. It feels quite nice quality. It's probably plastic as opposed to metal. Oh, no, that's definitely metal. Yeah, I was going to say. Yeah, definitely cold on my face. The bottom bit definitely is metal, good for heat dissipation and things like that. The top then is a plastic and that's fine. Again, it says Link Plus. And in general, it's a really good size. I mean, I can put my hand on there. You can see the size of it. You know, you're not going to notice that. It's really thin as well. So actually, that's really nice. And this stores 6 drives as well. It's got space for 2 2.5-inch drives, whether that's hard drive or SATA SSDs, and then space for 4 NVMe drives. And then it's got, you know, HDMI, USB 3.2 and everything else. You could use this as a media PC or just storage or anything you want, really, because the benefit of unRAID, and as I mentioned, this includes an unRAID license, but the benefit of unRAID is it's got loads of different apps. So whether you put, you know, Plex on there or anything else, you can actually, you know, use it through here. So this has really good connectivity. This also includes a 4-core Alder Lake CPU running up to 3.4 gigahertz and 16 gigabytes of DDR5 RAM. And I'll look at that a little bit more, but next I wanted to actually look at what's in the box. So basically, you get a user manual, as you can see there. I'm not going to show you everything, but yeah, it tells you how to install everything, you know, where to put the SATA hard drives, how to do the NVMe drives as well. It also talks about unRAID and, you know, the parity disk and things like that. You get an accessories pack as well, but that's just running through everything you need to know. And basically, yeah, it's a good manual. There's lots of detail there. You know, when you get this, you're not really going to have any issues, I think, understanding what you need to do. Next up, you've got a little card with a serial number and an activation code to actually activate unRAID, and it talks through how you actually do that. I'm just going to keep my finger over there, but you do also with unRAID, you've got the option of a trial as well. So you could always try it out for 30 days. And if you didn't like unRAID for some reason, you could always put like TrueNAS on your, you know, LinkStation N2 instead. You have got that option, but then you've also got the option of unRAID because it includes the license at no extra cost. I should say though that unRAID is a yearly subscription if you want the latest updates. So after 1 year of activating this license, you can either choose to just, you know, not get any more updates and not pay any more, or you could pay the price you can see on the screen now to actually continue to get updates every year. It's completely up to you. But that is the unRAID card with the license key and also the user manual. So we'll put that to one side. I'll move the NAS out of the way just a second. But next I wanted to go into the box and show off the rest of the stuff. And it's normal enough. You're going to get a power cord, which is going to vary depending on whether you're in the UK or Europe or America. And you've got the other side of the power brick too. There's not really much to say there. You just plug that into your LinkStation N2 and that's about it. And then we also get a couple of screws. I'm just going to break this. Brilliant. There you have it. So yeah, you get the screwdriver and the screws, and the screwdriver is magnetic, as you can see from the fact that, you know, I can pick up actual screws. So that is really good. But in terms of the LinkStation NAS, as I mentioned, it's actually supporting 6 different bays, and you access them through here in the first instance. So basically here, what you can do is clip down here and you move that out of the way. And that reveals the 4 NVMe bays. You can just see there, you've got 1, 2, 3, 4 bits to actually put the NVMe drives there. So nice and easy. And then they've got this snap-in thing which actually holds the NVMe drives in place, which is nice. It's toolless. You don't need to worry about screws and losing them or anything else. And the install is really, really easy. So you just put it in and then you hold that back and you clip in place and suddenly you've got your NVMe drive in there. And the nice thing with this is it's got a thermal pad as well. So that obviously doubles as a heat sink. So you've got heat dissipation from here and your drives are going to be cooled here as well. So then you just pop that back when you're done and jobs are good done. And as I mentioned, it supports 4 NVMe drives as well. So that is really good for connectivity, especially when coupled with the 10 gigabit Ethernet. And Jeff done a really good video on his second channel where he did test this 10 gig port and he consistently got that 10 gig throughput, so that is really, really encouraging. But yeah, the NVMe drives go in there, and then in terms of the SATA SSDs, or, you know, the hard drives, which are 2.5-inch, what you've got to do is pull that down. As you can see there, it's magnetic, so you pull it down there. You've then got Type-C USB port as well, which is really useful for moving data around and things like that. I mean, the connectivity on this is brilliant. And then you've got this L and R drive bay, so I'll just look at one of them because they're exactly the same. But you literally do that and it comes out. And in there, you put your drive. So you store it in there and then you actually screw it in place. And that's what the little black screws are for. Earlier, if you remember, I got absolutely loads of them. You'd actually screw your drive in place, your 2.5-inch hard drive or SATA SSD, screw it in, put it in. It's then actually going to be hooked up. You know, the actual SATA power and stuff is going to be here somewhere on the LinkStation N2 PCB. But the last thing I wanted to do was actually plug it in just so you can see what it looks like and what any fans sound like and things like that. So there we are, that's now just in setup mode. It's waiting for me to go to my web browser and actually, I think it's tower.local and set things up there as we've seen in the user manual. But this is the LinkStation N2. It's got an LED light there as well. That looks really, really nice. But basically it's a really, really impressive NAS. If you don't want to build your own one, then you could just use this and yeah, it'll work out really well. I'm gonna actually test this properly for the next few weeks and then do a separate video on it on my main channel, which is Tech Overwrite. But any issues or caveats or anything I notice, I will also put in the description here and in a pinned comment. But equally, if you don't see anything there, that probably means I'm quite happy with this product. If you've got any questions at all though, please do leave me a comment. And if you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more unboxings like this. Thanks for watching.